What is good, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. So, you guys, I just want to thank you so much for being here, liking, subscribing. I've been seeing all your comments, and I hope that you had an amazing holiday with your families and spending time together. So, today's video, I actually want to do January readings, but I want to do them kind of like all together in this video because, child, ain't nobody trying to make 12 videos, you know? So, and before we get started with this reading, I actually want to go ahead and plug my ebook, my tarot ebook. If you're wanting to learn more about tarot, how to do it, how to empower yourself, how to read the cards for yourself and get your own answers and be your own spiritual conduit, go ahead and grab that in my store. And also too, don't forget, you guys, I gave you the identity manifesto for free. Make sure you download that, make sure you get into it, make sure you love it, and you plan your 2024 out with who it is that you want to be. It's about 40 pages long, but I promise that it is worth it. All right, so let's get into this reading. Okay. We're gonna get into it. We're gonna start with Aries and work our way to Pisces. Everything will be timestamped below. But first, I actually really want to get out to you a channel message that I got in. And so I have this card called the Ever Unfolding Rose. And I'm gonna talk about this on my podcast. So make sure you follow me on my podcast. I'm gonna do more deep in depth over what the energies that are coming in January, what they're going to be like. But there's a sense for you guys to take a leap. It says you go first, the universe will catch you. And a lot of the times we think that we have to wait on something on the outside to happen before we get moving, or something to change, or a nudge of inspiration to try to move our attention into a new direction. So I'm seeing here that you need to definitely take that leap, that thing that you've been afraid to do. Take the leap and you will be supported. All right, and the Ever Unfolding Rose, it says cracked open. It's happening for you, not to you. So when I get this card, I think a lot about contrast. And with contrast, contrast is the opposite of what you want. So whenever contrast shows up in our life, let's say that, you know, we have been working a job for a long time, we've been doing well, and then they have layoffs and you get laid off of your job. And instead of seeing contrast in a way of like, you know, this is happening, you know, to me and this shouldn't happen, blah blah blah, I'm sure somewhere in your mind you've had the thought of you want more freedom or you want more time, and you know there's all these things that you deeply innately want, maybe the things that you have not even expressed. So when contrast comes in and shows you and gives you the opportunity to choose a new path or to make certain decision, and that we have Unbound here, it is releasing soul patterns, contracts, and past lives. So that it contrast usually comes in when it's a opportunity for you to move, to expand, to, you know, call yourself up to that higher level that you've been talking about going to. And a lot of the times we see contrast as something that is bad or something that is negative that's happening. And that's not always the case. Remember, it is always happening for you to bring your awareness and your attention onto what it is that you want. All right. But we're going to talk more about that. But I feel like that's what January's energies are leading us into, because it is a universal 8 year, which is all about abundance, karma, infinity, doing things for the long run, taking risk, death, rebirth, all that good stuff. All right, and so let's get right into Aries. Remember, it will be timestamped. If you guys hear my dogs in the back, you know how that goes. All right, what's good, Aries? Welcome to your reading, your January reading. All right, so listen, when I opened this box, all the cards flew out, and so we have the Three of Cups and the Six of Swords in reverse. So let's just see here what's coming out for you. I'm hearing even now, if you're watching this now before January, I think that you're feeling contradictory in your energy here. So there could be some things that's going on in your life right now that you're feeling like, I don't know what's going on, feeling like you need to heal, feeling like there's something that's coming crumbling down, or, you know, just kind of like something that's not very ideal that's happening for you. I'm hearing you're being redirected, Aries. So let's see what Aries has for January. Okay. I'm hearing, I don't know anymore. I'm hearing, I don't know. So Aries, there could be something like, because I'm hearing like you could possibly wake up overnight and just be like, I don't know if I want this. I don't know if I want to do this. I don't know if that's what I want anymore. But I know that I don't want to keep living my life this way. So there's something here about like you're, when it comes to like ideas and things like that, you may not be 100% clear on what it is that you want, or but it seems like it's something new. It seems like it's something that's easy. It seems like it's something that can actually take you on a journey here. So I feel like you're being called, or you want to go on a journey with this Two of Wands here. So this could actually be you taking some time to travel. This could be you expanding yourself, getting back into school, doing those things, really starting to make the plan, or actually really, you know, implant yourself somewhere. Is what I'm hearing. And it's like something about you want a do-over, something about 2023, you want a do-over. So we got the Star card here. So it's like you may want to see yourself in a different light. And we also have the Sun card here. So Leo energy, yes, Ace of Pentacles. You definitely want this new start. And I feel like this is something that you're going to be moving towards with the Knight of Pentacles. And it seems like it's something that's slow. And it seems like it's something that you're actually welcoming in. Let's see, what else for Aries? Clarify this Star card. It seems like it's lighthearted. Yeah, Ten of Cups. So whatever this, it seems like it's a lightheartedness about January. Like you're going into it feeling very lighthearted, very like, I'm hearing like a newborn baby, or like just with fresh eyes is what I'm hearing. Yeah, Ten of Pentacles at the bottom. Listen, it's like something about your world is being opened up, or your perception of what you can do or what you can achieve is being opened up. Yeah, we got the Fool in reverse here, but let's see. I'm hearing you could do it from right where you are. It's something about you may have the tools. Yeah, the will. You have the tools to do it wherever you are. So like I said, this could be traveling. This could be doing something online. I hear a plane going over right now. So this definitely could be about traveling. This could be you wanting to monetize something when it comes to traveling. But it seems that it's something that's going to be easy and enjoyable for you to do. Yeah, Ten of Pentacles, exactly. So let's see what else about this new beginning here for you. The World, listen, and the Eight of Wands. Listen, I think that for January, things are going to definitely start taking off for you pretty quickly. I just feel that it seems that you, although things, everything around you may be moving quickly, Aries, I see that you're actually the one like taking the steps. Like no one's rushing you. You're like, I got all the time in the world. I just know that there's something different that I want to do with my life, and I'm actually going to move into that direction instead of like whatever I thought that I wanted. So this seems like it's a new approach to something, or just something that's very brand new right now. And so it seems as if like, yeah, we got the two of Cups in reverse and the King of Swords. Like you don't have to make the decision right now, and you don't have to let anybody know right now, because I feel like this is something that's still being worked out within you, Aries. And so I feel like the more that you go through it, and definitely, yeah, work yourself through it. We got the Five of Pentacles in reverse. So it's like you don't want to rush, because you feel like there's nothing to lose, or there's nothing to, it's something about like you're coming from a time where things might have been like lacking a little bit, but now the way that you see yourself, the way that you see your potential is, you know, your perspective is definitely opened up. Like you've widened up, you know, your perspective here. So yes, we got the Eight of Cups on the bottom. So yeah, you're looking to move forward to something new. It just seems like, yeah, with this eight, lots of eights here. So you're definitely going to be feeling that abundant energy. It just seems like it's a clean slate for you, Aries, and one where you don't necessarily need validation or, you know, like praise for what you're doing. This is something that you're finding within yourself, and then you're going to move towards best case scenario for yourself. So it seems like January is just like a softening is what I hear. It's a softening for you to kind of like figure out, okay, like this is where I'm going, this is what I'm doing, this is what, where I'm headed. And you know, but you're taking it very light. It's like a lighthearted approach is what I mean by that. All right, so let me get you a card. Actually, let's see, card for Aries. Let's see, card for Aries. Let's see. double mission, channeling and uplifting humanity. Yes, and then we have awakening at the bottom. So this could definitely be because you are going through another upgrade, a level up, a spiritual awakening. And so it seems like you're here now to kind of do your mission here. So yeah, double mission, channeling and uplifting humanity. You might actually become a reader or like develop your abilities more. And I feel like that's where you're heading into, Aries. So it's an exciting January for you. And I'm super excited because of where I have Aries in my chart. And things are just going to work out for you. You have to know that, all right? So I love you so much, Aries. And I will see you guys on my next reading. So let's get into Taurus. Let's see. I'm going to need to open up a lot of these decks so that way we can just move from deck to deck to deck. All right. So let's see. Taurus, how is your January going to be? I'm hearing that saying, what, never back down, never give up, or something like that to that degree. It's like you're not backing down from something. All right, so what is this? Okay, so you've really been pushing forward on something. We got the Eight of Pentacles and the Five of Cups here. So there's something here that you're like, I could give up, but I'm too close. So what is this? I'm hearing I could give up, but I'm too close. I'm hearing I just know that it will work, or I just know it's working. So yeah. Yeah, you're decisive. Yeah, the Two of Swords in reverse. And then we got the Magician card here. So you are definitely decisive on what it is that you want. Whatever you're manifesting, whatever you're working on, whatever direction you're going into, you're pretty sure of yourself and you know that it's going to work out for you. All right. We got the Six of Swords in reverse. I feel like you're passing all logic right now. Yeah, the Chariot, you're still going to move forward on that Seven of Wands. What is this? Maybe other people may be trying to tell you like, oh no, you shouldn't do this. Yeah, King of Wands. It's because the way you see yourself, you're like, look, I'm hearing I'm big shit right now. I'm doing my thing. Like, I feel like nothing can stop you in January with whatever you're doing. I feel like you've been trying all year, something about clothing, making clothing, doing something about like with aesthetics, and you've really been trying hard. Some of you could be going to beauty school or starting back beauty school or doing something to that degree, but it's like you already know, like it's going to work out for you. Yet Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, it's definitely working out in your favor. So I feel like you just know, like, this is the direction I'm going and this is what's happening. Four of Wands. Yeah, my stability is in this. And I also feel like, too, like, you could be, I'm hearing some of you could be getting married or some of you could be, you know, becoming into more stability with a person or closer into union with a person once you get more stable within yourself. We have the Devil card here. So, yeah, this is definitely about work. Let's see. What else? Yeah, listen, you're no longer looking back. You're trusting yourself. We got the High Priestess card. So this could also be online too, like you're starting an online business. And then we have the Ace of Pentacles here. So I do see that this new opportunity, you're ready for something new. I split the deck. We got the Death card. Yeah. So I think it's a different perspective shift, or you seeing yourself completely differently, which is why things are working out in the way that it is. Yeah. Eight of Pentacles again, and the Hierophant and the Three of Swords here. What is this? What is this Three of Swords? Okay, so I feel like you're I'm hearing silencing doubt, or you're silencing the I can't do that, I don't know for sure, the limited mindset here. But we have the Eight of Pentacles and then the Hierophant here. So you're definitely coming into more union with what you're doing. Seven of Cups. I feel like you're narrowing your options. I feel like you got a really good handle on where you're going in your perspective in your life towards in January. And just seems that you're just like picking up the momentum from where you left off in 2023. And it seems to be working out for you. Things are just definitely going, I feel like you're going to hit your stride at some point in January, like the middle of January. And it's like gonna be, because I see like it going up from there, and I see like a store, like a Shopify store or something like that. The, you know how like if you ever seen it, like the numbers, how they go up, I kind of see that for you. So I feel like whatever you're doing, it's working and you're sure of yourself and you're gonna keep going in that direction. All right, so let's just see what we have for my Tauruses. Break the chain, ancestral patterns, healing, rewriting the future. Exactly. The things that you couldn't do or you didn't get a chance to do in 2023, I feel like you are definitely you got a little bit more like connected to what it is that you're really doing, and you believe in it now. I think it's because you believe in it now, and you believe that this has the power to take you wherever you want to go, whatever this is, whatever you're doing, even if it's just a mindset shift. And what it's doing is it's propelling you forward, and it's bringing in what you really want, the success that you really want towards. So I just feel like January is gonna be starting out really good for you. All right, so let's get into the next sign. And I love you, Taurus, and I wish you the very best. Okay, so let's see. Okay, we're doing Gemini next. So Gemini, I'm hearing get ready for the best year ever, Gemini. Get ready for the best year ever. Okay. Let's see. What's going on for Gemini in January? Okay, the Four of Swords, the Emperor in reverse, and the Wheel in reverse. What is this? We have the Five of Cups on the bottom of the deck. Let's see what this is. Knight of Swords in reverse. Two of Cups. Page of Cups in reverse. Ace of Swords in reverse. Okay. All right, Gemini. So I do feel like things are getting better for you. When we talked about it in your last reading, we talked about you actually really moving forward because you are a visionary. I do see here that you may be kind of like stuck, or there may be, you know what I'm getting? Because I'm getting with this Two of Cups here. This is the only card that's in the upright, and with the Four of Swords here. So I feel like you're kind of like, I'm hearing holding on for dear life, or holding on, like kind of still holding on to like, oh, I may need more time. I don't know if I'm fully ready. I'm still healing from this or that, or whatever didn't work out before. It's kind of giving that. And I feel like you're bypassing your intuition here. Yeah, we got the High Priestess and the Hermit card. Listen, so it's kind of like you're stuck still in analysis paralysis. Let's see, what else? What else for Gemini? Ooh. Knight of Wands in reverse, and then the Judgment in reverse. Yeah, Judgment in reverse, Three of Cups in reverse. Listen, I feel like Gemini, you may have a case of like dimming your light down because you know how good it could be. You know how amazing your life could be. You know how really far you could take that thing if you actually apply it. And I feel like it's just a little bit of like, oh, like restricting yourself and not going against what it is that you really want. You may have a rune tattoo, runes, or you may be into runes. You may be a reader yourself, but it's something here about you may care about other people's thoughts, or even just, let's say you're selling something, or you're wanting to speak up about something because you are about communication, third house communication. So I do feel like you may want to speak up about something, but you're confused on if people will like what you have to say, or if people will actually accept you or accept whatever, it's like this is a deep hitting feeling with the Moon card here, but it's also a lie is what I'm hearing. So let's see. I feel like Gemini, like it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. Yeah, Five of Cups in reverse. Listen, you have to take a stand with the Page of Wands and go for it. We got the Ace of Wands in reverse. Yeah, you're not really going for it. Queen of Cups. Listen, we talk about it all the time. Listen, man, I cannot make this up. Listen, when you surrender, we talk about this all the time. Queen of Cups, when you surrender to, I don't know exactly how, but I know that I have to do this. I know that I can do this. I trust in the process. That's the gift right there in the surrendering. Because when you surrender at the bottom of the deck, we got the Fool. There's the new beginning. You're free. You're opening your wings. You're flying for the first time. You're trying something new, and you know that you're going to be supported. You just have to know that people want to hear what you have to say. People are looking for what you have to say, Gemini, whatever this is or whatever you're doing. People need to hear it, but you have to want to hear yourself and want to see yourself being. I'm hearing something about being loved by many, or being accepted by many, or being seen by many. You have to be okay with putting yourself out there for other people to, you know, like what you do and accept and receive what you have to say, all right? So it could be about you getting over the fear of that, surrendering to the possibility that everybody may not like what you have to say sometimes, and people may love what you have to say sometimes, but that's the beauty about contrast, what we were talking about. Yeah, King of Wands in reverse. So I do feel like you possibly could just be in your way about this. You could be in your way and, you know, not standing in your fullness here. So I do feel like once you remove that doubt and you surrender, I'm like, I'm just going to try it anyway. I'm going to see. I feel like you'll be pleasantly surprised. All right. So let me get a card for you. I'm being called to take this one off the bottom. Starseed, what lights you up? And trust your path. Yeah. If you knew you would be supported, what would you do? That's what you have to look at. If you knew that you would be supported no matter what would you do? What would you do, Gemini? If you knew that you would be supported no matter what, no matter the ups and downs, like, how would you move? That's what you need to think about in January. And once you settle that within yourself, I promise you, you're going to take off, all right? So let's get into Cancer. Cancer, let's actually open another deck. All right, Cancer, let's get into it. Let's get into it. Okay, Cancer, I'm hearing the old me is dead and gone. There's something that could be resolved for you. We got justice at the bottom. Yeah, there's something that could be coming in that's being resolved for you. Seven of Swords in reverse. There could be something that's happening right now that could be shaking you up a little bit. Yeah, the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. I'm hearing something about, like, hold on, let me get the cards out because I'm getting a lot of downloads for my Cancer gang. Let's see. Cancer. What's going on for Cancer in January? Knight of Wands, listen, Knight of Wands, listen, the door is wide open, Cancer. I keep hearing the old me is dead and gone. So listen, the door is wide open for you to move into the assumption, or to move into, because something about, like, dropping the conflict with the Five of Wands in reverse here. Let's see, Ten of Wands at the bottom of the deck. Yes, listen, do not doubt the work that you've been doing on yourself all last year in 2023, the setbacks, the pain points. They're all growing pains is what I'm seeing. The Eight of Swords, Cancer, you've had to learn how to trust in yourself. And I'm hearing, and not to trust in the world or trust in what's happening, but trust in who you're being. Does that make sense? So let's see. Seven of Cups, listen, you have so many options, so many outlets available to you. I feel like there's many things that you can do in January and you will be supported. Clarify this Ten of Wands. Six of Cups, listen. Six of Coins, excuse me. So yeah, this is like a gift. This, whatever you're ending here, or whatever cycle that you're ending here, this could be a big major cycle. This could be the, because I'm hearing, like, with the wands, it's about doing and achieving. And we talked about this a lot, but I feel like for my Cancers, it's a lot for you guys to try to hold on to yourself emotionally and hold on and try to control that, your emotional feelings and beings. And let me tell you, the full moon in Cancer was yesterday. And let me tell you guys, it was like I was working through some emotions. So I know you guys felt it, but it's like I'm hearing from the concrete a rose grew. So you're in this phase of, like, really growing right now, Cancer. But it's like something that beautiful that's growing out of what is dead already. That's what I'm seeing. Yeah, Six of Wands. Listen, you're gonna recognize your own power in January, Cancer. There's something that you're doing where it's like a self-recognition or a gift, or like a it's something about, like, I'm hearing, don't think about how or don't think about when. Think about, like, because I'm hearing appreciate yourself, Cancer. I'm hearing appreciate yourself. Camera died. But like I was saying, Cancer, I'm hearing appreciate yourself. Right now in this moment, you need to appreciate yourself. Appreciate how far you've come. Because it's something about you could be seeing, like, because I keep hearing the shadows. Like we were talking about in that last reading I did about shadows, about things that may be appearing still, and you feel like, you know, like, oh my gosh, like this is happening to me, and this is happening. It's like, no, I feel like spirit is really kicking you out the nest. Yeah, Four of Coins in reverse. Like, yeah, you cannot stay stable here. This is, you cannot stay in something that has already, the cycle is past, Cancer. So I feel like this new beginning, this Knight of Wands, you have to see things with new open eyes and a new perspective here. Let's see what else. Your financial situation too is going to be getting better, Cancer. Yeah, Ace of Swords, new, brand new beginnings, all right? A brand new way that you're speaking about your circumstances, a brand new way that you feel about yourself, a brand new way that's going to bring, make a way, I'm hearing, out of no way, okay? I'm hearing, I don't know why I'm getting all, like, you may be spiritual or like the Bible, but I'm hearing a lot of Bible verses right now. So you could be someone who's deeply in prayer right now, or someone who's trying to, you know, get themselves like on the right, in the right mindset, the right headspace, the right something here. So what else for Cancer? The Knight of Swords. Listen, a lot of knights here. So listen, I feel like minimal effort or minimal movement is going to do you some good. It's something about, like I said, even this is for me too, because I'm feeling this for me too. It's been a lot for me to try to fix things or try to like overcome, feeling like I'm always having to overcome things instead of just like doing what I can or moving my attention away from what I don't want to, and starting to put attention into what I want. And it doesn't have to be super dramatic or like, so let's just say that you started something like a YouTube channel and you're like, oh, I gotta post videos every single day. I need to post videos every single day. And then you put this sort of amount of pressure on yourself. But it's saying when you go into this slowly. Make meaningful content. Make the content that lights you up instead of like just making it because you feel like you have to like do a lot. That comes from like a space of lack, is from always feeling that you just have to do something because like that's what you're doing. Because less sometimes is more is what I'm hearing, Cancer. Listen, and when you do that, the Wheel of Fortune, all right? There's some abundance that's coming in for you that you may not know where it's coming from, is what I'm getting. It's like, it's, I'm hearing it's in your orbit. It's already in your orbit, but you have to align yourself to that. And it's by relaxing, minimal movement, letting go of the past, and accepting this gift in this new cycle to move forward, all right? Because I'm hearing whatever you've been through is a gift, all right? Let me get one more for Cancer. Yeah, Chariot in reverse, and then we got the Temperance card. Listen, be patient with yourself. Yeah, stop trying to move fast. Stop trying to move fast. Stop trying to move in a hurry and balance yourself. Be centered. I'm hearing meditation may do you some good, or bringing yourself back to the present moment is always going to help you, because that's where expansion comes in from the Temperance card, which is Sagittarius, Jupiter energy, expansion. So coming back to center is always going to be your best bet, all right? So Cancer, let's see what we got for you. Let me get a card for Cancer. Deep replenishment, retreat, rest, and be held. Listen, that be held just hit me here. That be held hit me, yeah. Listen, be held in the moment. Let the universe take care of you. Let the universe guide you. Let yourself be replenished and let yourself be, let yourself be carried. Let yourself be loved on. Let yourself be feel love. Feel supported, all right? Let yourself feel that you have all of your needs now, Cancer, all right? I feel like someone needed to hear that, all right? So I love you so much, Cancer. And we're going to head on to Leo. I'm going to head on to my Leos. Leo. Let's see. Leo, let's get right into it. Whew, I feel like I needed to take a deep breath. I keep hearing bring your awareness back to the present moment. I don't know why I keep getting that for you guys. Like, bring your awareness back to this present moment. Page of Cups in reverse. Let's see. Leo, Temperance in reverse. Yeah. Listen. Seven of Wands in reverse. You got the Ten of Cups, Ten of Pentacles at the bottom. Listen. It's not so much about doing, Leo. It's not so much about trying to, because I feel like you're doing all the, I'm hearing extra steps for nothing. I feel like you may feel that you have to be more than what you are to be worthy of success, or to be worthy of the money, to be worthy of whatever you think that you have to be worthy of in order to get it. Because it feels like it's like a hidden energy from you right now. Six of Wands in reverse with at the Fool in on the bottom of the deck here. So let's see. What is this? Clarify the Temperance card. Nine of Swords. I'm hearing to let it go. Four of Pentacles in reverse. Leo. Knight of Cups. Okay. That person may be coming in. Like, now for some of you guys, I know we talked about this person last reading, but if the person has not come in for you yet, I feel like this person is coming in to clear things up. I have split the deck and we got the Five of Swords in reverse. So this person could be coming into definitely, yeah, Five of Wands in reverse. So yeah, there's changes between you and somebody this month in January. Three of Wands in reverse. Why is all these reversals here? The Hermit card. Listen, it might be, you may be just on in January, you may be just focused on pulling your energy back in towards you, because I feel like this is not a lot of outside effort of trying to do things, of trying to achieve things. It seems as if you're taking a little time out for yourself. You could be vacationing a little bit, you could be spending New Year's with family, or like I'm hearing moving or moving around, like getting yourself together, like really just taking it easy walking into 2024. So it seems like, yeah, Two of Cups, like, listen, this person is going to come in and you guys may reconcile. Yeah, the Lovers, man, what did I say, Leo? For sure, you're reconciling with someone, for sure. Let's see, what else? Ooh. I feel like this is going to be freeing for you. We got the Judgment card. I feel like things are just like, it's something about like lightening up or freeing you. Yeah, from the situation. Nine of Wands. Like things are coming to an end between the old ways of being. This person may bring you a gift, but they also want to collaborate. I feel like this person is going to answer a lot of questions that you feel like should have been answered from when they left, or like whatever happened between you guys. I feel like it's something about you're not going to have to do a much of talking. It's this person that's going to like definitely be talking and, you know, catching you up on what happened. They're going to be so excited. But I feel like your energy is very reserved for January. Like you're reserving all your energy for yourself and for whatever you want to work on. It just seems like because it's like not going to be a lot of confusion right now. This is sticking out. So yeah, this is a Ten of Cups. So you just want to, I'm hearing you want to feel fulfillment right now, or you want to feel peace right now. And that's what you're looking for. That's what you're looking for. Yeah, we split the deck, the Devil in reverse. So it's like, yeah, you don't want to really start anything up like deeply, but you want to feel like, you know, I'll have the conversation and I'll see what happens. But it's just like your energy is very reserved. You feel very peaceful. Yeah. Seven of Swords in reverse. Deception is gone. It just seems like it's a clean slate for you, Leo. Page of Wands. Yeah. Something new is definitely happening for you. And I just feel like you want to take your time to let it marinate is what I'm hearing. And to like definitely resonate. All right. So yeah, at the bottom of the deck, we got the Initiation card. Exactly. Rite of Passage, crossing the threshold. So yeah, that's what it seems like. It feels like, it just feels like this, I don't want to say like a waiting thing, but it just seems like it's like a area of peace. Like you're just walking into a peaceful environment. Let me get one more for you. Keepers of the Earth, you are not alone. Ancient ancestors stand beside you. That's beautiful. All right. So yeah, it just seems as if you're like you're just chilling, you're relaxing, you're just letting things be as they are. And I don't know, it just seems very like nice. Oh, we got lions on this card. So yeah, that's you. You're awakening to this new level for yourself, Leo, and I just love it. But yeah, this person is gonna come in, they're gonna be like all about you, wanting to talk to you. Like they're gonna be doing most of the talking, all right? But yeah, Leo, I hope that this resonates and I wish for you an amazing, amazing, amazing January, okay? All right, so let's get into Virgo. Virgo, why am I hearing a Pretty Little? Is it Pretty Little Liars? The theme song. There's a secret, gonna keep it. Na-na-na. I don't know. It's like yes, yeah, it's a secret. I'm hearing that. It's a secret. It's a secret. Let's see what this is. See, I'm hearing hold your cards close to your chest, Queen of Swords. You're taking a stand in something, Seven of Swords in reverse at the bottom. So I feel like you're standing up to something. You're standing up to life, or you're standing up to deceptions. You're standing up to false things, or things that you feel are not true. Let's see what this is for Virgo. Eight of Wands. Listen, things are moving fast for you. Wow. Tower card. Things are definitely moving fast for you. High Priestess. Wow. What else? King of Cups in reverse. King of Swords in reverse. Six of Swords. Okay. I feel like following your intuition. You're following your intuition about something with the King of Cups in reverse and the King of Swords in reverse. I feel like this is not a masculine approach, is what I'm getting. This is not like a doing approach here. Wow, we got the Ten of Cups. Listen, I feel like people are gonna watch you get something, Virgo. I feel like people are definitely gonna be watching you get something, or something is coming in for you that it's like people are gonna be able to see your abundance, or people are gonna see you could be getting a large sum of money or something like that, or a partnership. Or married or whatever, but it's like it seems like you're finally getting your flowers, or you're getting the recognition, or you're getting the happiness. Yeah, Knight of Wands in reverse. What is this? This doesn't seem small. Four of Cups. Ace of Wands in reverse. Let's see. Virgo, what else? Ooh. Five of Cups in reverse, the Devil in reverse, and then we got the Ace of Cups. I'm hearing everything's always working out for me. Everything's always working out for me. Split the deck, we got the Six of Coins. Everything is always working out for you, Virgo. I feel like that could be your mantra, but it's something about everything is working out for you. Yeah, the Lovers in the reverse, Two of Cups in reverse. What is this? Let me get a clear read on this. Wheel of Fortune, Nine of Swords. Look, okay, this is what it is. You're transcending. You are transcending your circumstances. You're transcending something that kind of rocked you for a little bit, or is rocking you for a little bit, or you feel like that there's something that's happening that may be unfavorable now, but I'm hearing it's working out in best case scenario is what I'm hearing. So I feel like if you just listen to your intuition, you're only trusting your intuition now. So let's say that something could be going on that's like very major, like very, very major. It seems like something's going on major right now, and you're like just trusting. Because whatever this is hidden. I feel like it's already taken care of, but it's going to come through in a way that you've never thought it would come through. All right, yeah, we got the King of Cups in reverse and the King of Swords in reverse. Like, there's no action or no dominant action that you need to take for this, or no seeking outside of you for this. It's just about you internally rising above the circumstances. I've never seen this. Here she has all these swords here around her, but like, in the essence, she's rising above all the circumstances, bottom of the deck, Queen of Wands, and doing it with confidence and authority is what I'm hearing. Yeah. The Moon card here. Yeah, this is something that you can't see. I'm seeing, yeah, it's like something, yeah, hidden. Something that's a little hidden for you, but it's going to come through. All right? I don't know why I'm hearing the Harry Potter Patronus, the Patronus charm that was like his, you know, you guys know. If you're a Harry Potter fan, you know. But it just seems like it's something about, like, you're defeating something. You're defeating something in January. And it seems as if, like, there's nothing else that you really need to do. You just need to listen to your intuition. You could just be kicking, things could be crumbling around you, because I'm seeing somebody kick up on the couch and read their book, like, look, because it's something about, you may just not know how, you just may not know how this is going to happen, you may not know, but what you can do is you can stand in your assumption and in the authority that you know what's best for you, that you can decide what's best for you, and that you can decide that you can control your energy, and it just seems like everything works out for you. All right, let me get one more. Yeah, Seven of Swords in reverse. Listen, I'm hearing the battle's already won. Yeah, Chariot in reverse. Listen, there's nothing that you have to do. There's nothing that you have to do. Things will be working out for you, Virgo. Believe that, all right? Believe that. Even when it gets scary, believe that, all right? So let's see. Transformation. Listen, things are changing at a cellular level. Deep healing. What did I say? Yeah, you guys are definitely transforming. It kind of, it's like a presence about you that is changing. Something that's transforming about your present, awakening, energetic upgrades, a new way of being, integration. Yeah, that's what it is. It's like you're no longer fighting the process or fighting to try to be right or fighting for your limitations is what I'm hearing. You're just accepting the transformation and the awakening, and you're allowing yourself to integrate with the changes, with the conflict, with the contrast, whatever it is, you're allowing yourself to adapt, all right? And that's not easy for you, Virgo. So I definitely feel like, listen, ooh, excuse me, I'm hungry. But the more that you take your attention off of it, the more that things are just gonna work out for you effortlessly, right? So let's see, who do we got next? We got, we got Libra. Libra. I'm hearing, baby, won't you come my way? Baby, won't you come my way? Oh my gosh. Somebody wants you to give them attention, Libra. Let's see. What's going on with Libra for January? Magician. Wow. What's going on for Libra? Ooh. Four of Pentacles. Ten of Swords in reverse. Clarify the Magician. The Hierophant. Someone wants to come back in a union with you. We got the Empress at the bottom of the deck. Someone wants to come back in a union with you, Libra. And it just seems like, yeah, they're not ready to stop talking to you, or they want to talk to you again. Like, they want to open back up communication. They want to be in union with you. Yeah, Ace of Swords in reverse and the Hermit card. Yeah. But I don't know if you're open to it, because it kind of seems as if, like, you're in this kind of phase right now where you're just chilling. Like, you're meditating. You're getting your life right, getting your goals together for 2024. Yeah, the Four of Pentacles. You just may be over the situation. Wow, I split the deck. We got the Knight of Swords in reverse. So this person, like, is running back to you, but you may not want them to, like, come back. What else? Devil in reverse. Yeah. I feel like you're trying to get yourself to a stable place energetically, Two of Pentacles. What else? And then the Five of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah. Listen, you've just come out of a really like tough cycle when it came to relationships and setting boundaries in place and, you know, providing justice for yourself, Libra. And I just feel like right now you're just trying to balance the physical and the spiritual or the mental right now. And so, yeah, King of Pentacles in reverse. So this person seems a little intrusive on your energy, but I feel like it's just because they know that you're not talking to them and they want you to still talk to them. Yeah, Page of Swords, like something about they want to put like ideas in your head. Four of Wands in reverse with this person. So this person is not stable. I feel like you've forgiven this person because I saw the Three of Swords in reverse, but you're just kind of like, I don't know. Yeah, Strength in reverse, and then the Ten of Wands. Ten of Wands in reverse. Listen, I think this person is like, look, we have to talk. I have to talk. This person doesn't want to walk away. Why is that? Knight of Pentacles in reverse. Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, because they're not happy without you. And then we got the Temperance card. There's deep transformation that you're going through, a deep expansion that you're going through right now, Libra. And so it's like this person is kind of like, I have to say something before they move on. All right. What else? Queen of Cups. Yeah. Listen, you're focused. Ace of Cups, High Priestess. Look, I don't think you're open to this right now because you're like, look, I'm focused. I'm trying to get my Zen together. I'm trying to get my emotions in the right place. I'm trying to, if you're recovering from something, you could be like recovering. Some of you could be sick right now. You could be recovering, but it seems it's something like something to the degree of like, I don't want to hear anything about love is what I'm hearing. I'm just trying to get myself centered is what I'm seeing. So Libra, like this person is definitely coming in to talk, but I feel like if you don't move your stance from how you truly feel, split the deck, we got no. It says no, wait, postpone, pause, say no. And then we got transformation here. You're still going through a transformation. So it kind of seems to me that you're like, look, you're going through this transformation and this person is kind of coming in while you're in the middle of that. All right, we got the yes in reverse, so that is still kind of saying no there. So listen, and the initiation, rites of passage, crossing the threshold. Yeah, you're going through something right now, like you're going through major upgrades in your life right now. So this could even be like, you know, a not right now, we may not need to have this talk right now, but maybe at some point we can, but just not right now in this moment. That's what it feels like. All right, so Libra, I love you so much. All right. And you know what you're doing is best for yourself. All right. All right. So let's get into Scorpio. Scorpio. Let's see, Scorpio. What is going on with my Scorpios? What is going on with my Scorpios? All right, Scorpio, let's see what's going on with you. What's going on for January? We got the Six of Pentacles in reverse, the Four of Swords, and then the Eight of Pentacles in reverse. You're coming off the tail end of something. What is this? Ten of Pentacles. Devil in reverse. Listen. Clarify the Eight of Pentacles for me. Judgment. I'm hearing that song, Don't Take Your Love Away. It's an Avant song. It's an old song. Baby, don't take your love away from me. I need you, girl. Don't take your love away. Listen, you maybe have taken your love or your energy away from someone and they feel judged. Let's see. What is this? Because we have the Ten of Pentacles here. The Devil in reverse. Yeah, the High Priestess. You turned your energy back onto yourself. Yeah, Nine of Cups. You got right back into the receiving mode. And I'm hearing you could be a little brat about it, but I don't see that this is a bad thing. It seems as if like you're like, look, no, if you're not putting in the work with the Eight of Pentacles in reverse, like I'm judging you. Like I'm judging you. Like I'm not going to give you the time of day. Like This could be a relationship that you're actually in right now, but it's something about this relationship. It's like with the Four of Swords, it's like it's been hard, it's been heavy, it's been like things have not been working out for you, but it's like, let's see. Yeah, Three of Pentacles in reverse. Like right now, what it is like, look, it's like you're taking some of your attention off of this person so you can focus on yourself for the long run, for what you want for the year. So it seems as if like you dealing with this person is kind of taking away from yourself or working on yourself or like drawing up a new vision for yourself. So it could be definitely this person didn't give you a gift for Christmas or something like that. Six of Pentacles in reverse, and then the Four of Swords here. So it seems, yeah. What else? Ooh. Hermit in reverse, and then Two of Wands in reverse, Tower in reverse. Listen, the Tower in reverse is just escaping something or just like just missing something here. So it seems to me that you're like not giving this person like a concrete decision, but you're judging them based on what they've done or how they've treated you, how they are treating you. And it seems as if like you're like, look, I got to take my attention off of you because I still have to figure out what I'm doing with my life. I got to figure out what I'm doing with my life and where I'm going. So yeah, Nine of Wands. Yeah, new cycle's ending. Yeah, we got the Magician at the bottom of the deck because you're calling in something new. You're creating something new. Yeah, Queen of Pentacles. So yeah, you could be focused on your own money, your own bag right now. And this person may not be contributing to you for where you're going right now in your life. Let's see, what else? The Strength card. Yeah. Yeah, because they didn't recognize you. Six of Wands in reverse. So it seems to me that, yeah, you're focused on bigger and better for yourself and for your life right now in January. And so, yeah, Nine of Cups again, like into that receiving mode. If you're not giving me what I want, yes, Three of Swords in reverse. I'm taking it. I'm taking that L and then I'm leaving. I'm moving on. I'm doing what I got to do for me. So it seems as if, like, I'm hearing, like, some, yeah, Five of Cups in reverse. So it just kind of seems like you're kind of over it. Like you're like, look, if I've been telling you, if you're not going to do it, this is what it is. And that's just what it is. So I don't know. I'm just seeing that everything is like working out for you in the best ways, but it feels like you may be taking time away from this person or like actually deciding to call it quits with someone. All right. And let's see. Let me get a card for you on what is going on. Wait, they're telling me to take a look at your finances really quick. Finances for Scorpio. Death in reverse, Ace of Cups in reverse, Three of Wands in reverse. Listen, if you're trying to make some investments right now, wait for just a moment because I feel like things are clearing up for you. Things are clearing up for you, yes. Because I feel like the path is going to be laid out for you to actually move in a new direction. So it seems as if like there's maybe something you're wanting to transform in your business or what you're doing or your career, or you're trying to figure out where you want to invest for a house or where you want to move, where finances are moving around to, that sort of thing. But it seems like, yeah, we got the Four of Wands in reverse, so it's kind of like you don't just make anything stable or concrete just yet. Keep figuring it out. I'm hearing keep waiting for the answer. Yeah, Ace of Wands again. Yeah, so there's a new beginning, a new start. Ace of Swords in reverse. Don't make any concrete decisions on if something new is popping into your life. Kind of like really look at it a little bit before you actually take that deep dive and say, yes, this is what I want or this is what I'm going to do. All right. So, the Age of Light. You've been training for this for a lifetime. And what else? Longing for home, belonging, the original light workers. Yeah, you could be like trying to find your place in this world or definitely trying to find a new home or trying to find some peace, some solitude. So yeah, it's just, yeah, you're trying to move on to the next best thing for yourself. So it seems like this person may be kind of in the way right now. So you're just kind of like, look, I gotta like detach from you for a little bit so I can figure me out, you know? And there ain't nothing wrong with that, all right? So Scorpio, I love you so much. And I will see you guys on my next reading, all right? So, who's next? Sagittarius. Sagittarius. Let's see what is going on for my Sagittariuses in January. I'm hearing don't put so much pressure on yourself, Sag. Let's see. You may want to come out the gate swinging in January. Like, all right, I got these goals. We're ready to go. You got 10 of coins. Like, you could already see the dollar signs. You could already see how it's going to play out. You could already see, like, how it's, whatever you're doing is going to be beneficial for you and your lineage here. And it seems as if you're like, look, I'm ready to go. King of Swords, Six of Coins in reverse. I'm hearing slow and steady wins the race. Let me see. Slow and steady wins the race. If you're partnered up, you could be deciding to have children with your partner. Let's see. Clarify this. Yes. Six of Wands in reverse. It's not fully time right now to like actually act on what you're wanting to achieve right now. It seems like you're ready to go for it, but I'm hearing not right now. Six of Coins in reverse and the Six of Wands in reverse. So, listen. I'm hearing, hold on for just a minute. Yeah, King of Wands in reverse. So, yeah. Four of Cups in reverse. I'm hearing, don't put the cart before the horse, all right? So, if there's something that you're doing or something that you're working on, you're really going for it, battling, doing what you got to do, and it seems that if it's like, okay, but I know this is the way, I'm hearing just before you put it out there, a jump far ahead, really take a listen to see what's really going on internally for you, all right? So, yeah, the Emperor card. Yeah, make sure that you are... It's something about like you want to be stable and solid and sure, like you are, but at the same time, this 10 of coins, you're already thinking about the abundance before the actual grounding and the being sure of yourself. So this is the focus right now. You have Five of Cups at the bottom of the deck, so I'm hearing embracing polarity. I don't know why I'm hearing that. Embracing polarity, kind of like the contrast we were talking about. Nine of Cups receiving, yeah, the Sun card too. So let's see. Why the need to not move forward yet? Seven of Wands, you're still building it. Yeah, Nine of Wands in reverse. Yeah, it's not quite ready yet, all right? So don't jump too far ahead. We got the Judgment in reverse. So it's like... It could be off, yeah, Eight of Wands. You want to move really fast when it comes to this. And it's just, right now may not be the best time. I'm hearing crossing your T's and dotting your I's. Yeah, Ten of Wands. Yeah, the cycle has yet to fully close out for you. Even back in, because I'm hearing in December, there's still some things that are playing out that are wrapping up. But I feel like it's closing. The old cycle is closing, and then you're able to make a move in this new cycle. Wow. Ten of Cups. Yeah. Listen, once that cycle wraps up, you'll see the way clearly. You'll see the way more clearly. Yeah, because right now, Five of Wands at the bottom of the deck. It's just not 100% like, I know this is what I want. You know what the outcome looks like and the money and all that. Like, you're sure of that. But the little in-between things, the setting up your back-end systems, that sort of thing, or like making sure you have your passport, making sure you have documents. You could be moving. Yeah, Two of Wands in reverse. So, yeah, if you're not 100% sure, don't do it just yet. All right. Anything else for Sag? What is that? It's a Tower card. Yeah, don't make any sudden, like, shifts or changes right now. Like, nothing sudden. Nothing jumping out there fully right now. Yeah, the Eight of Swords, because you're still working on unveiling parts of yourself, all right? There's still things that you're personally working on so that when you do this thing or whatever this is all you. And you have to be completely sure of yourself being the Emperor, being stable within yourself. So if you do have little setbacks, you know that you can overcome them or, you know, recover pretty quickly. Like, there's those sort of things. So you're not thinking about that right now. You're thinking about, like, when it pops off, it's going to be this, all right? So there's a lot of in-between things that need to happen there, all right? So let's see for you guys. Also, I'm hearing hang out with your friends, Sag. hang out with your friends a little more next month. Don't be so tied up into, like, you know, because something about, like, recognition in reverse. Like, so you just may not be recognizing the gifts that you do have right now with the people that are in your life now, like the people, your family, that sort of thing, in the Nine of Cups here. Yeah, so it's like there are people that definitely want to hang out with you, want to be with you, want to enjoy your company and your presence, and they're like, you know, we just, you know, need you to, like, yeah, breaking the chain, ancestral patterns, healing, rewriting the future. Yeah, so spend the time with your family, spend the time, like, healing and rewriting your future. So yeah, and then I split the deck, we have the Leap card. So yeah, that's you definitely needing to take that leap, but you just need to wait until, like, you kind of just enjoy. I'm hearing enjoy January, because it's like it seems to be like a recovery month for you, and you're already like, I'm about to go make this money, I'm about to go do this, about to go do that. And it's like, wait just a little bit, you're gonna get to that, it's gonna happen. But right now we need to relax, we need to chill, we need to process how 2023 did us in. Okay, all right, Sag, so I love you. All right, my Cappies, Capricorn, let's see what's going on with my Capricorns. All right, let's see what's going on for my Capricorns in January. Hierophant. Some of your birthdays may be in January. Happy birthday right now, Capricorns, for you guys that are in December. All right, so yeah, we got the Death and Rebirth at the bottom of the deck. I feel like you're coming into this new level of yourself, like a new awakening of yourself, Capricorn. It seems like we talked about in our last reading that featured you, everything that you really thought that you wanted, it's kind of like you let go of the idea of those things, and now you're just kind of moving from a place of being. I feel like you're becoming more one with yourself in this moment, and it's leading to this big transformation. So your birthday could be really pivotal for you. Clarify the Page of Swords in reverse. Queen of Wands in reverse. I don't know why I'm getting over this trying to keep up, or trying to keep up with beauty standards, or trying to make sure that you look a certain way or are a certain way. I think you're making peace with that, or like learning your confidence doesn't come from those things. Let's see, the Hermit card. Yeah, Fool in reverse, Tower in reverse, Sun, and then the World card. Listen, like I said, it's like you're letting go of the things that you think are making you happy, or the things that you feel like you need to be in order to have this new start. And it's like you're going inward now. So this is a time for you to go inward about something, and having strength here. Yeah, strength. Two of Pentacles in reverse, Page of Wands. It seems like a very new start, but there's the Justice heading in for you. I'm also getting reconciliation with partners, and if you're married, like, you guys will be coming closer together. But you guys will just be closer together. Yeah, Ten of Pentacles. Mm-hmm. Like family. Like there's a family reconciliation there, or getting closer with your partner, closer with your family. So it kind of just seems like the more that you focus into that and being present in the moment, all those other little things start to fall away. Does that make sense? All right. We got the High Priestess at the bottom of the deck. So yeah, you're becoming more in tune, learning how to be the magician, how to direct your life, instead of like, I think I should be this, I think I should do this, I think I should try this, and being like, no, like, we're good. Yeah. Six of Cups, like, not looking back. Let's see what else. Oop. Nine of Wands, yeah. So you're looking for something new. You're looking for something new, but yeah, Ten of Cups here. Looking for a new level of fulfillment with your loved ones, your family, your kids. So it seems like you're more off of work right now in January, and you're coming more into like balance with yourself, and then with your family, and spending time with the people that you genuinely love. Yeah. What else? Yeah, Chariot in reverse. Ooh. Five of Wands in reverse, and then the Moon card. Seven of Wands in reverse, Three of Wands, Five of Pentacles in reverse, Six of Swords in reverse, and then the Lovers in reverse. Yeah, you're not going to be go, go, go. You're not going to be trying to do all this stuff. You're really not. Like, Five of Pentacles in reverse, like, you're like, look, I thought I wanted to make all this money. I thought I wanted all these things, but what I want is a future. I want travel. I want love. I want peace. I don't want to work so hard. And it's like, something about it doesn't even have to make sense, or it doesn't have to be a reason why, or something like that, to that degree. Yeah. It's like, it doesn't, it's like you're the way that you're feeling now, it's not coming from a I need, or I think that I can be better, or I think it's something about, like, you're okay with the way that you are now. Let's see. King of Swords in reverse, Queen of Cups in reverse, Four of Cups. Ooh. Seven of Swords, Four of Swords in reverse, and then the Nine of Cups. So I do see that you are moving on towards something new. You are moving on towards something new in your happiness here. There may be still a little bit of struggle to actually fully let go and to fully embrace your path, but I think that you will actually be moving forward towards those things and towards your new life. It just kind of seems as if, like, you have to kind of, like, have those meetings with yourself about, like, is this what I really want to do with my life? Am I really on the right path? That sort of thing. All right, Capricorn, so let's go ahead and look at a card for you. Let's see. Don't dim to fit in. How are you dimming your light in order to fit in? Exactly. Birthing a new age, birthing new creations, dreaming a new world into being. Exactly. It's like you know, if you're a hard worker, because all the Capricorns I know are hard workers, if you are someone that works hard, you're like, you know what, I don't think I want to do that anymore. I think I want to relax. I think I want to, you know, enjoy my family, enjoy my friends, enjoy my life. You could be at that point in your life where you're like, I've done all the things, and now I just want to relax, and I want to feel more free. I want to feel more happy, at peace, comfort, that sort of thing. So it just seems that everything is definitely working out for you. All right, so we're actually going to move on to Aquarius. We're gonna see what's going on for Aquarius. What is going on for Aquarius? I'm hearing time's up. This could be that, because we got Pluto going into Aquarius. This could be that, like, whole thing. Let's see. Four of Coins in reverse. Yeah, time's up for something for you, Aquarius. Page of Coins. It could be a job that you're at, have been at for a long time. Like, that could be up for you. Ace of Wands. Yeah, it's time for you to start something new. All right. So yeah, I'm getting the time is up for you. I'm hearing you got to get out of your comfort zone. There's something that you're being called to do, or called to actually get out of your comfort zone. Yeah. King of Wands in reverse. Clarify the Page of Pentacles. The Lovers in reverse. I feel like you, something about come out of the shadows, or come out from behind other people, or dimming your light for other people. I'm hearing something about coming into union with yourself. Knight of Wands in reverse. And then we got the Six of Swords in reverse. Yeah, this is about transcending your current limitations, or your current circumstances. So there's something that's coming to an end here for you, and you need to be at a point where you're, like, moving yourself out of your comfort zone to start something new. So, because I feel like whatever you're doing now has just been stagnant with the Page of Coins. Like, it hasn't really yielded you the fruit that you really want. So, yeah, something about, because you could elevate. It's like you're at a point where it's like you're afraid to actually elevate into that King of Wands position. We got Page of Wands. Yeah, you still see yourself as someone that's smaller, Knight of Coins. Like, everything that you're doing right now is, like, not indicative of what you can really be doing, what you can really be putting your energy into, putting your attention into. We got a Three of Wands in reverse. So it seems kind of like you may be feeling like you're regressing is what I'm hearing this month. But I'm hearing in that it's, yeah, with the Moon card, this is for a reason here. What is this? Clarify the Moon. Four of Wands in reverse. So yeah, your stability could be just a little rocked or shaken. But I think it's because you're not listening to your intuition. You're not listening to what it really is. You're not answering the call is what I'm hearing. Nine of Cups for more, to receive more. So yeah, it's kind of like right now you're kind of cut off from receiving more, or from receiving more information, more downloads. So yeah, Three of Cups in reverse, and then the Nine of Swords again. Yeah, so I'm hearing, I don't know why I want to say stop fucking around is what I'm hearing, and like actually move in that direction or actually do something new, because it's something about you could be upset about your circumstances. We got the Queen of Swords in reverse, but then you're actually not doing what you know innately that you need to do or that you're called to do when it comes to whatever you're trying to achieve here. Mm-hmm. Five of Cups, yeah, like you're unhappy about your situation. Devil in reverse. I'm hearing there's nothing really there, yeah, but Seven of Swords, but the lies you keep telling yourself. So let's see, anything else on this? Judgment, yeah, listen, you fear judgment. I don't know, I never met an Aquarius that really be fearing judgment like that, but you know, it can happen because it's something about like you don't want to make the wrong mistake, or you feel like there's a potential for you to make the wrong mistake, and so you don't really move. Eight of Swords, yeah. So like you're doing the work on yourself, because look at that, we got the Star in reverse here. So you're learning more about your star power, but it seems like I'm talking to someone who's like very early 20s, very like, or mid 20s, something to that degree. But it's like you don't feel like you fully have grown up yet is what I'm getting. This feels like someone that's being called to actually step into like a little bit more of a grown-up energy, but you're kind of holding yourself back. Eight of Coins from doing the work, and the death is in reverse at the bottom. So yeah, you're holding off on transforming, but the Ten of Cups is right there, and you just may be fearful because you just don't know like what that really entails. But I'm hearing it's a hero's journey. Yeah, I'm hearing it's a hero's journey. Ace of Cups, Ten of Coins. Yeah, listen, things are working out for you, but you just have to be intentional about actually moving into this new, being ready to learn something new, being ready to try something new, being ready to stand for something new or stand on something new is what I'm hearing. Let's see. Sun card, the Empress, and then the Two of Cups in reverse. Listen, if you're someone that likes to talk to people before you actually go do something, like, oh, I was thinking about doing this, what do you think? And then you wait for their response before. It's something about like getting away from that, because with the Empress, you have to be steady, centered, secure with yourself, and happy with yourself and for your own choices, whatever that is. We got the World card at the bottom of the deck. Yeah, you can, something about like you could take on the world with what you do. I think you're just, it's giving you more afraid of your power here, Aquarius, is what I'm getting. Ace of Swords in reverse, Two of Swords in reverse, Two of Wands in reverse. So you're not 100% certain. Page of Swords, Death in at the bottom again. You got to get past seeing yourself as this is just good enough, or where I'm at is just good enough. You get what I'm saying? Yeah, there's so many knights and pages here, so, but they're all in reverse. Let's see. Six of Wands. Recognize that you're more than this. Recognize that what you want is on the other side of fear, or letting go of the judgments of others. Exactly, the Fool card here. We got the Knight of Cups here too. So taking on a new emotion around you actually moving or growing into this phase. You could kind of see it as like a process of like, oh, like things, everything is getting better for me, or I'm learning new things. It's about switching your perspective instead of like, this is going to be hard because it's going to require me to like, you know, be out there or do this or do that or express myself more. But, you know, you don't have to get there fast right now. Right now, you have to be willing to go on the journey to learn something new, to admit to yourself that you don't know everything, and that, you know, becoming the star, that really takes a little bit of like a process to really find your own unique thing that makes you a star. All right. See ya. All right, at the bottom of the deck, we got just say yes. So yeah, we got the yes card. You just have to say yes, and you just have to, like, you got align your life. What is not aligned or needs to change? Exactly. So you need to be aligning your life. Where are you being called to journey to? Exactly. So you're being called on a journey right now to actually, like, step into your star power. And it may be a little uncomfortable, but I feel like if you have to recognize that everything you want is on the other side of your comfort zone. All right. And if you've been staying comfortable, like, things are going to keep getting, you know, more and more contract until it just kicks you off of that timeline. Like, that's how that works. So if you're not moving, you're going to see that things around you are going to start to crumble until you actually, like, are forced to make a jump, and it may not be in the way that you want. All right. So just, you know, start small and actually work towards it, you know, and you got this. All right. So let's get into Pisces. What is going on for you, Pisces? You know, I saw this other reading the other day, like on TikTok, and this lady was talking about how Pisces was going to have, like, one of the best years, like a year of comebacks. And I really believe that, because I feel like for Pisces, it's always like hit or miss, or up and down in emotions, up and down in with people, that sort of thing. So it just kind of seems like things are going to be moving in a new direction for you. So what's going on for Pisces? We got the Hierophant in reverse, the Knight of Swords in reverse, and the Strength in reverse. Clarify the Hierophant in reverse. The Knight of Wands in reverse, the Knight of Swords in reverse. Wow. Death card. Listen. Listen. Okay. Yes, Pisces. I'm hearing a forced change. So this, you could be going through something in January that's more like a forced change or a forced recognition, a recognition of something about, like, the old ways were not working. Yeah, Six of Wands in reverse, like the old ways were not working. The way that you were going to find your confidence was not working. You could have been moving back towards someone else, and it just kind of, like, didn't, something about going back to the old people, old friends, that sort of thing. It's like, I'm hearing all that has to, yeah, transform. We got the Three of Swords here. And then we also have the Four of Pentacles. So I'm hearing that it's time for you to come back towards yourself right now. Man, Four of Swords here. So absolutely, this is time for you to really come back to yourself so you can think clearly, so you can transform. So I feel like things are already, like, moving for you right now. The Moon card, the Five of Pentacles in reverse, the Chariot in reverse. Listen, you got to accept, because it's something about March that's very significant. The Emperor card. It's like, by that time, you're going to be feeling much more different. So this seems like an energy clearing, like a lot of, like, those old feelings, those old things that are resurfacing. So you could do the work on them. I just saw the Eight of Pentacles. So you could do the work on them, or you can acknowledge and release them is what I'm hearing. You may not have to sit there and, like, comb over everything and, like, oh my gosh, like, what's happening with this? What's happening with that? Like, no, it's you actually doing the work. Ace of Wands in reverse, Ten of Pentacles. So yeah, everything is working out for you, but you may just be a little confused on, like, where to start, what to do, what should I be working at, what should I be looking at, what should I be doing, this and that. And it's like, no, I'm hearing be here, be now. Yes, slow down. Eight of Wands in reverse. Don't start overthinking it, because it's like you may be feeling overreacting or getting really emotional about the situation, and you're like, I don't know what's going to happen, or I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. You're supposed to be coming into balance with yourself. You're supposed to be establishing a different relationship with yourself. Yeah. Journaling, possibly, really getting your ideas in order. Yeah. Not looking at from happiness on the outside, but looking at it from, like, within you and what you have now. Yeah. Let's see what else. Ace of Cups in reverse, Knight of Pentacles in reverse, and the Empress in reverse. See, right now is not the time to like really get moving and really be trying to jump ahead for this new start. Right now, it's meant for you to sit with yourself, to be with yourself, to be present with yourself, to like move past certain emotions and to move past like something about familiar structures, like family structures, things that have been programmed into you. Yeah. Something about like you, something about like people may take advantage of you or may take your kindness for a weakness, that sort of thing. But it's like, I think this heavy feeling of everything being pulled away from you is so you can see that you really did not need it. You're learning how to stand on your own, Pisces. Yeah, Nine of Wands and the Ten of Swords. Listen, I'm hearing keep quiet about it. You don't have to really go with talking about it to people because I feel like that's what perpetuates the cycle of you being, like, some people may perceive you as, like, being a victim or someone that always is going through something or, you know, it's kind of like, yeah. So right now, Eight of Swords in reverse. You have to turn your attention on yourself and face yourself in the mirror is what I'm hearing. What else? Six of Cups in reverse. Yeah, don't be too nostalgic with the way that you used to do things and holding on to the past and, you know, I got to do this and this is the reason why this is happening. That I'm hearing like none of that matters. It's just so you can pass, like literally pass, like the energy, the feeling needs to pass through you. And that's something that you can do in silence. Yeah, Two of Cups in reverse. You don't have to tell your friends. You don't have to express it. You don't have to try to like cover it up and move forward with trying to do new things and trying to manifest things, you know, as you're kind of feeling in a hurried state or rushed state. The best thing that you can do is like bring your attention to the present moment and stay calm, Pisces. Yeah, give yourself that attention. Yeah, Three of Cups in reverse. Like, don't talk about your friends with about this with your friends. And then we got the Six of Pentacles here. So your root and your sacral chakra is definitely being worked on right now. So the feelings that you have, the sense of security, your creativity, all those things that you feel, yeah, hang them in here. It's like something about like the more that you're by yourself, you're going to start to see how a lot of things were an illusion. Yeah, Two of Swords, Ace of Pentacles in reverse at the bottom. It's something about like you feel like you've been set up to fail, but you're not. So it just seems like a lot of things coming to light and you have to get comfortable with being with you, taking this journey by yourself, walking this path with just yourself. And I feel like I said, by the time we get to March, Aries season, things are going to just start to feel like more settled. You're going to feel like you know what to do. Like you're going to know how to approach situations. You're going to know how to defend, not necessarily defend yourself, but you're going to know how to like be there for yourself without like feeling defensive. So this is about like really softening and getting out of anxiety, yeah, opening up to receive. And like what, like I talked about with contrast, that's very big because with contrast in the negativity, we think it shows us more of what we actually do want, not more of what we don't want. Because if we're focused on the contrast and thinking like, oh my God, this is coming into my reality, it's going to take me out, it's going to do this, it's going to do that, you could actually look at it and say, wait, this is here to show me actually what I do want, not focusing on what I don't want, but what I do want. And what I do want is healthier relationships. I want to feel good by myself. I want to feel stable. I want to feel secure. I want to feel like, you know, I'm not having to depend on anybody. I want to feel like comfortable with myself and comfortable with my life and comfortable with my career, comfortable with what I'm doing. I just want to feel comfortable with me. I want to feel okay with me. Without all that, the old stories and like the shit that I've been through when I was younger. That's what this gives me, all right? So anything else for Pisces? Six of Pentacles, yeah. It's about sitting with you, balancing yourself out and not giving into fear. Not giving into fear of being by yourself and working and feeling those emotions when they come up. All right. Let's see, Pisces. These cards are so big. Soul family, call in your tribe. You don't have to do this alone. I feel like right now, like, yes, you're going to be finding your soul tribe when you step back and you're okay with yourself. So it feels like you're going to be starting out this process of you actually finding yourself and really deepening your relationship with yourself. And then once you have that stable, the people, the correct people that will be there for you and uplift you, not into a victim state, but actually, you know, call you forth to more expansion. Those are going to be the people that are going to come in your life. So it's going to be the people that you need for this next level. Yeah, the initiation, rite of passage, crossing the threshold. Yeah. So it may feel like you're unsure right now, but listen, lean into that is what I'm hearing. Lean into that. Break the chain, ancestral patterns, healing, rewriting the future. Exactly. You're just going through clearing a lot of old habits from, you know, your family and things that have been passed down to you that really are not your problem, right? So Pisces, I love you so much, and I will actually see you on my next reading. And if you made it all the way to the end, you guys, I love you guys so much. Don't forget to get my ebook. I'll see you guys on my next reading.